Good morning, and welcome to St. Andrew's for Transfiguration Sunday, and happy Valentine's Day to all who are celebrating. I'll ask Pastor Neil to please provide the announcements.
Yeah. Good morning, everybody. I want to thank everybody for questions of the faith. At this point, and if you still have yours, I don't want to discourage you from getting them in. Please do. But at this point, I've got more than I can use for Lent. So I will be planning actually a sermon series. So all of the questions that are asked are addressed. I really think that's important. And if you have a question, it's important that it does get addressed. So I don't know exactly when, probably at some point after the Easter season, but thank you for those. Ash Wednesday begins Lent this week on obviously Wednesday at 7 o'clock. So join us for Zoom. Like all services, we won't be opening up right at 7. We'll be opened up a little before that. If you are forgetting any of the Zoom information, please be reminded you can get it by going to the website and it'll be there. Either on the face page, will it be on the face page, David?
Or
Ash Wednesday.
Yeah.
Yes, either right there on the first page, you can link right onto it, or if you want to, you can go via the calendar as well. Be reminded of the St. Andrew's Social, not this week, but that happens next week, February the 23rd, 6:30 to 8:30. And that's a stop in or stay the whole time. And it's just a time to come together and shoot the breeze. That's all it is, no agenda. Okay. So we prepare ourselves for worship by using the brief order for confession and forgiveness as is in your bulletin. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose voice is upon the waters, whose mercy is poured out on all people, whose goodness cascades over all creation.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin, trusting in the abundant grace of God. Holy God, you search us and know us. You are acquainted with all our ways. We confess that our hearts are burdened by sin, our own sins, and the broken systems that bind us. We turn inward, failing to follow your outward way of love. We distrust those who are not like us. We exploit the earth and its resources and fail to consider generations to come. Forgive us, gracious God, for all we have done and left undone. Even before the words are on our tongues, you know them. Receive them in your divine mercy. Amen. How vast is God's grace. Through the power and promise of Christ Jesus, our sins are washed away and we are claimed as God's own beloved. Indeed, we are forgiven. In the wake of God's forgiveness, we are called to be the beloved community, living out Christ's justice and the Spirit's reconciling peace.
Amen.
Stepping in for Mark here as he had an emergency phone call, please join us for our first hymn, When Morning Gilds the Skies.
Thank you.
At this point, I know we're supposed to begin service, but obviously Ron had to step away very, very quickly. Please keep them and in your family until we know what's going on in your thoughts and prayers, please. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who offer their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, the resplendent light of your truth shines from the mountaintop into our hearts. Transfigure us by your beloved Son, and illumine the world with your image through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The first reading is from the second book of Kings, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. A reading from 2 Kings. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So then they went down to Bethel. The company of prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he said, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Elijah said to him, "Elisha, stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they came to Jericho. The company of prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he answered, "Yes, I know. Be silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went and stood at some distance from them, as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to the one side and to the other until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing. Yet, if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted to you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended into a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." But when he could no longer see him, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 50 will be spoken responsively. The mighty one, God the Lord, has spoken, calling the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting.
Out of Zion, perfect in its beauty, God shines forth in glory.
Our God will come and will not keep silence, with a consuming flame before and round about a raging storm.
God calls the heavens and the earth from above to witness the judgment of the people.
Gather before me, my loyal followers, those who have made a covenant with me and sealed it with sacrifice.
The heavens declare the rightness of God's cause, for it is God who is judge.
The second reading is from the second book of Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 3 through 6. A reading from 2 Corinthians. Even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. In their case, the God of his world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For we do not proclaim ourselves, we proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord and ourselves as your slaves for Jesus' sake. For it is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 9th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now, as I begin to read this, be with these disciples. Just imagine with them. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice, "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So hopefully you imagined at least a little bit. Okay? This was an incredible thing that happened. Okay? And put yourself in those disciples' place. You know, this is Mark. You have now in Mark walked the bulk of Jesus' ministry with him, a couple of chapters, and we are at Holy Week in Mark. Right? It's a shorter book. So you have been with him. You've been called. You left everything. You saw the miracles and the teachings and all of these kinds of things. Jesus has certainly said he was the Son of God, very consistent with what he taught, but he was still a human being. You were raised as a Jew to understand God as the God of creation, God a little separate. How do you make that all not be a part of your thought process? Wouldn't it have been a struggle? Well, a little proof would be nice, wouldn't it? A little proof. Now, we like proof, don't we? We base our legal system on it, right? Now, which state is the show me state? There's and then I'm gonna forget off the top of my head. Some of you know. or the proof is in the pudding, or, you know, we've got all these things, right? We want proof. Of course, I like the proof is in the pudding one. I just as soon be the one tasting the pudding, but yeah, no, right? But so Jesus takes these few up on the mountain. And they get proof, don't they? Can you imagine? Here's Jesus as this human. They know him as a human. They have walked with him. They have eaten with him. They have gone to bed because they're exhausted with him. They have done all of these things, right? Very human things. And they witnessed him do some things, but oh man, this was different. And it overwhelmed them, didn't it? It overwhelmed me. Now, if you think about what happened here, you know, truth in its extreme form sometimes does overwhelm. Many times I have accompanied family members to see a family member who has died. I need proof. I need proof, they often say to me. And when they see the proof, it's incredibly overwhelming. They don't quite know what to do with it. To be sure, that's what we're talking about here. This proof that Jesus was the Son of God. Moses and Elijah, it'd be overwhelming. So, of course, Peter puts his foot in his mouth. Peter always puts his foot in his mouth. Let us build a couple of booths. We'll hang out up here a little while. But he didn't know what to say. Now think about this for a minute. Of course, Jesus says, don't say anything to anybody. Right? And that makes some sense. Not that I believe they didn't tell the other disciples, because you know they did when Jesus was out of earshot. But that aside, when Jesus died and rose again, do you think they went back to this? Do you think this helped them put all the pieces together? Here in this transfiguration, we see the vastness that is God. Right? God was more, is more than the humanness of Jesus. While that is certainly a huge part of how we understand God, God was more than that. Moses and Elijah. This is my son. Listen to him. There's more pieces here. God is vast. God is huge. And understanding that, or if you will, understanding that we can't understand it all, is so important. Is so important to really grasping what we celebrate on Easter. Right? This was not just simply a human thing. They witnessed God in a way that they hadn't before. Right? My dear friends, this is the same God that stands among us. This is the same God where we can see the brilliance of that love that expresses itself in so many different ways that Nancy experienced just a few days ago, right? Or yesterday, Nancy. This is how we experience this love. It pops. It's here. It's bright. Right? This is the brightness, the vastness of what is God. So we take that. We take this peace that God gave the disciples and gave to us. And that's how we walk Lent, knowing full well that God is more than just human. God is that miracle of 1 + 1 = 1. And this is this other piece of one. We can share that brilliance with the world. And the world desperately needs this light. Amen.
Please join us for our second hymn, Beautiful Savior.
We confess our faith by using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Guided by Christ, made known to the nations, let us offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all people in need.
For the gospel proclaimed in word and deed, for communities of faith far and near, and for all who show the face of Christ throughout the world, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For creation, sun, moon, and stars, life forming in the dark earth and oceans deep, mountains, clouds, and storms, and creatures seen and unseen, and for the Holy Spirit's guidance in our stewardship of God's creation, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For those responsible for safety and protection, for emergency responders and security guards, attorneys and advocates, civil servants and leaders of governments, that they witness to mercy and justice throughout the world. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For all who suffer this day, especially Kelly, Peter, Rob, Barbara, Matthew, Colson, Pastor Sue Ruggles and Jim, Pastor Neil Mittelstadt, Audrey, Helen, Doreen, Pam, and Ruth, Jean, Marlon, Laurie, Chris, Earl, Sean, Lisa, Pete, and Jim, Colin, David, Carl, Al, Lori, John, Florence, and Glory, that Christ our healer transforms sickness into health, loneliness into compassion, bereavement into consolation, and suffering into peace. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
In thanksgiving for the faithful departed who now rest from their earthly pilgrimage, that their lives of service and prayer inspire us in our living, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
We pray for Good Shepherd Lutheran of Easton and the Reverend Becca Mitakee Conlon.
Have mercy, O God.
Merciful God, we pray for an end to the pandemic COVID-19. We are thankful for the creation of a vaccine. Speed that vaccine to a world who needs it. Comfort those who have lost loved ones, and send your healing spirit on those who are ill. Help us be thankful for those working on the front lines. We name Cindy, Nick, David, Joe, Jim, Linda, Tom, and those we name aloud or in our hearts. Keep them safe in your protective care. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God. Dear God, at this time, we are in thanksgiving for the union of Gretchen and Jack. And dear God, we pray for them as they continue in their life together. Bless them and their families in all that they do, that they may continually grow in your love and in love for each other. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
We pray, dear God, for the Roth family. For whatever they are going through right now, dear God, we pray that you would hold them up and strengthen them with your mercy and love. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent. For the sake of the one who dwells among us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
These are the days.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love, through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Blessed are you, O holy God. You are the life and light of all. By your powerful word, you created all things. Through the prophets, you called your people to be a light to the nations. Blessed are you for Jesus, your Son. He is your light, shining in our darkness and revealing to us your mercy and might. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his preaching and healing, his dying and rising, and his promise to come again, we await that day when all the universe will rejoice in your holy and life-giving light. By your Spirit, bless us and this meal, that refreshed with this heavenly food, we may be light for the world, revealing the brilliance of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Taste and see that the Lord is good. The body of Christ given for you.
Amen. The body of Christ broken for you.
Amen. The blood of Christ shed for you.
The blood of Christ shed for you. Let us pray. Christ Jesus, at this table we have feasted on your very life and are strengthened for our journey. Send us forth from this banquet, nourished in body and in spirit, to proclaim your good news and serve others in your name.
Amen. Now, God, the Creator, strengthen you. Jesus, the Beloved, fill you. And the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, keep you in peace.
Amen.
Please join us in our closing hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
Go in peace. Be the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.